Hello students, today I am going to solve Business Studies question paper of Nios class 10th. Students, question number 1 to 10 are multiple choice questions, where for one question, 4 options are given and you have to select the best option. So let's begin. Question number 1. Which type of activity is to give donation to flood and earthquake relief fund? So the correct answer is option D, non-economic, because people give donations not to earn profit, not for monetary benefit or gain. Question number 2. The membership of this form of business organization is open to all those who have a common interest. The correct answer is option C, cooperative societies, because people join cooperative societies for a common interest. Let's go to question number 3. Which mode of transport is most feasible in hilly and mountainous areas? The correct option is option A, road transport, because in your book also, chapter number 5, advantages of road transport, it is mentioned that road transport is most feasible in case of hilly and mountainous areas. Question number 4. The type of warehouses that can be set up only after obtaining a license from the government is D, public warehouses. Question number 5. Oral communication includes communication with the help of the following. So oral means relating to sense of hearing. So the correct option is C, bells. Question number 6. Wholesaler is an important link between D, producer and retailer, because we have studied chapter number 13, channels of distribution, that wholesaler is a link between producer and retailer. Question number 7. Non-store retailing does not include option A, multiple shops, because in non-store retailing, we do not have any kind of shop. Question number 8. This right enables you to select the best quality item. So the correct option is B, right to choose, because as per this right, you have the choice to select the best product suitable for yourself. Question number 9. BIS means. So BIS stands for option B, Bureau of Indian Standards. Question number 10. Activities like hand spinning and weaving, hand knitting, etc. comes under the following area of self-employment. So the correct option is option C, village and cottage industries. Students, question number 11 onwards, there are questions mentioned for which you have to write the answer. We start with question number 11. Buying and selling through internet may take place round the clock between business units in different parts of the world. Identify the concept. So students, the concept is e-commerce, that is electronic commerce. And explain any two advantages. So students, chapter number 2, page number 38, advantages of e-commerce are mentioned. There are 5 advantages, you can write any two. So students, question number 12, they ask you about manufacturing and construction industries and giving 2 examples of each. So manufacturing industries are those industries which transforms raw materials into finished products. Their examples are on page number 33, chapter 2. Examples are textiles, chemicals, sugar industry, paper industry, etc. And construction industries take up the work of construction of buildings, bridges, roads, dams, canals, etc. This is how you will solve question number 12. Question number 13. State any 3 limitations of air transport. Students, chapter number 5. Limitations of road transport. 1. It is not economical for long distance transportation of goods due to their limited carrying capacity. 2. Transportation of heavy goods or goods in bulk by roads involving high cost. It has high cost. 3. It is affected by adverse, or you can say bad weather conditions like flood, rain, landslide, etc. Question number 14. Give a short note on Consumer Protection Act 1986. This is a very important question, and every year this question is asked. So students do this question very well. Students, the answer for this question is on page number 258, chapter 17. Consumer Protection Act 1986. This act provides for consumer protection more comprehensively, it means in more detailed form than any other law. Consumers can seek legal remedy for a wide range of unfair practices, not only with respect to goods but also for deficiency in services like banking, insurance, etc. It is also mentioned that this act also includes provision for establishment of consumer courts councils at center and state. So it means this act also gives provision for establishment of consumer courts like district forum, state commission and national commission for redressal of consumer disputes. So you can write the short note like this because it is for 3 marks. So this much is enough. Question number 15. This is a large scale consumer's cooperative store which sells a wide variety of products like food items, vegetables, fruits, groceries, etc., as well as durable consumer goods under one roof. Identify it and explain its two limitations. Students, you have to identify. So here I would like to tell you that sometimes indirect questions can come where you have to identify the concept. So here, this large-scale consumer's cooperative store is called Super Bazaar because Super Bazaar is a large-scale consumer's cooperative store which sells a wide variety of products like food items, vegetables, fruit, groceries, as well as durable goods under one roof. I hope this is clear. In the question, it is also mentioned to mention any two limitations of Super Bazaar. So, on chapter number 14, you can mention the first one is heavy investment, second lack of efficient management, third is no credit facility. So students, there are three mentioned. You can write any two. Question number 16. Explain unlimited liability and principal agent relationship as two features of a partnership business. So students, you can explain this question from chapter 3, features of partnership, where it is very well mentioned in point number 5. That the financial obligation, liability means financial obligation. So the financial obligation of all the partners are unlimited. It means if the assets of the firm are insufficient, not enough to meet the liabilities, the personal properties of the partners, if any, can be utilized to meet the firm's liabilities. Students, the next feature which is asked, principal agent relationship, again from chapter number 3, features of partnership. This means that when a partner deals with other parties in business transactions, he or she acts as an agent of the others, and at the same time the other becomes principal. So there always exists a principal agent relationship in every partnership firm. It means one partner can represent the business firm as an agent and others become the principal agents. Question number 17. Explain the principles of indemnity and mitigation. Students, answer for this question is from chapter number 10, insurance and principles of insurance, where the third principle, indemnity, the purpose of this principle is that the insured is not allowed to make any profit from the insurance contract on the happening of the event that is insured against. Compensation is paid on the basis of amount of actual loss or the sum insured, whichever is less. So the insured party cannot exploit the contract. And basically it means to restore someone to the same position. And this is applicable only in case of fire and marine insurance. It's not applicable in case of life insurance because the loss of life cannot be restored. The next principle asked in the question is mitigation. According to this principle, in case of any happening mishap, the insured must take all possible steps to reduce or mitigate. It means to reduce, to diminish the loss or damage to the subject matter. He should not behave irresponsible. I mean, the insured should not behave irresponsible. And the insured is expected to act in a manner as if the subject matter has not been insured. He should take all those steps as much as he can reduce the the loss or the damage. Students, let's move to the next question, number 18. Explain any four advantages that companies can get by outsourcing their back office operations to third world countries. So this is from chapter 11, outsourcing, where a company can outsource one of its process to some another third party provider who is best for the process or who is specialized in doing it. Students, on chapter 11, advantages of BPO, that is business process outsourcing, is mentioned, where, as it was discussed in class also, that once a process is successfully outsourced, it means we give it to some other party outside, more time. I mean, the company will get more time to explore new revenue generation activities, accelerate other projects. Basically, they will get more time to focus on core and important activities of the business. So there are many advantages mentioned. Five advantages are mentioned. You can write any two. Since the question is of 4 marks, you have to write any four advantages in the exam. Question number 19, which form of business organization exists under Hindu law and is governed by the law of succession? Explain it briefly. So students, the form of business organization which exists under Hindu law is called joint Hindu family business. It is also known as Hindu undivided family business. This form of organization exists under Hindu law and it is governed by the law of succession. In the question, since it is of 4 marks, you have to explain it briefly by also mentioning that it is a form of business organization in which family possesses some inherited property, that is maybe from forefathers. The inheritance of the property is among the male members only, which are called co-partners. Three successive generations can simultaneously inherit the ancestral property. And who is responsible for managing the business? It is the Karta. Since it is of 4 marks, you can also mention the features of joint Hindu family business also. That is membership by birth, who is doing the management? It is Karta. Liability, Karta is only liable for in case of any loss, no maximum limit. Minor members are also, they can also become the members and affected by death. Once if Karta dies, the next senior most male member becomes the Karta of family. So you can mention these. Students, question number 20, state any four functions of a wholesaler. So students, first of all, you have to define who is a wholesaler. Wholesaler is a very important middleman in the chain of distribution who buys goods in bulk from the producer and sells in relative smaller quantities to the retailers. There are many functions performed by wholesalers, such as collection of goods, financing, storage of goods, risk taking, distribution, and grading. So you can read this on page number 197, chapter number 13. Question number 21, what is meant by national objectives of business? Explain any three national objectives of business. Students, chapter number 1, we have studied that there are 5 objectives of every business. And the fourth one is national objectives, that is all those objectives that we have towards our nation, our country. Students, page number 15, chapter number 1, national objectives. Every business must fulfill certain national objectives also, such as creation of employment, that is providing employment opportunities, generation of employment opportunities, promotion of social justice, production according to national priority, contribution to the revenue of the country, and self-sufficiency and export promotion. These are five important objectives and the national objectives that you can mention in the question. Since it is of 5 marks, you can mention 5 national objectives. Question number 22, what are commercial banks? Commercial banks are those banks which deal with general public and businessmen. They accept deposit and give loans. Explain three types of types, giving one example of each. So students, you know that there are three types of commercial banks: private bank, public bank, and foreign bank. On chapter number 9, banking, we have types of commercial banks, as I told you: public sector banks, private sector banks, and foreign banks. So you have to give example of each. So in public sector bank, we have State Bank of India, Corporation Bank, Bank of Baroda, etc. In private sector banks, we have the Jammu and Kashmir Bank, ICICI Bank, Development Credit Banks Limited, etc. And in foreign banks, we have Citibank, American Express Bank, Standard and Chartered Bank, etc. You can write the answer like this. Question number 23. Explain the concept of personal selling. Students, personal selling refers to face-to-face presentation, interaction, and persuasion of customers to buy the products. And also, in the question it is asked, explain its four essential elements. So, since you all know that that in chapter number 16, we study about sales promotion and personal selling. So, in this part, it is very well mentioned that personal selling refers to a process where the person directly interacts with customers, he or she motivates and encourages the customer to buy the product. Now, it's also mentioned essentials, elements of personal selling. So, it is face-to-face interaction, persuasion, that is to encourage, to induce the customers to buy the product, flexibility, as per different age or as per different customers, the personal seller has to adapt and adjust himself, promotion of sales, supply of information, and mutual benefit. These are the essentials of personal selling. Question number 24, explain right to seek redressal and right to consumer education as the rights provided by consumers by Consumer Protection Act 1986. Students, every year rights are asked in the question. So there are 6 rights and they can ask you all of them or maybe one or two of them in explanation. Right to seek redressal, students, means that if the consumers are deceived on the part of sellers or service providers, like charging high price, selling inferior quality of or unsafe products, then the customer has a right to seek remedies. Remedies in the sense, right to get the defective goods replaced or money refunded by the seller or dealer. The consumer has the right to seek legal remedies in the appropriate courts of law. Next, students, in the next part of this question, it is mentioned right to consumer education. So, consumer has the right to be informed or educated about 3 important things. First, the relevant laws which are aimed at preventing unfair trade practices. B, the ways in which dishonest traders and producers may try to manipulate market practices to deceive consumers. And the last one, how consumers can protect their own interests. Also, the procedure to be adopted by consumers while making complaints. So, a consumer has the right to be informed about all these 4 essential points. Question number 25, explain the meaning of wage employment and self-employment, giving suitable examples of each. Students, wage employment means an occupation in which a person works for another person or serves another person, gets wages or salaries. Self-employment means a type of occupation in which a person is working in his or own firm and he is his own boss, not serving any other person. For example, If a doctor is working in a hospital, then he is involved in wage employment. But if he opens his own clinic, then he is engaged in self-employment. You can give this example for teacher or for any other type of occupation. The next part of this question is why is self-employment considered better than wage employment? This is important and this question can be asked. Self-employment is considered better than wage or over wage employment because it offers opportunities for using one's own talents for one's own benefit. Self-employment is possible even with the resources of capital and other facilities. Also, in self-employment, the person learns many things on the job because he has taken all decisions regarding his business activities for his own benefits. So students, these three points are very important from chapter 19 that you have to remember. Question number 26. Explain any four features of joint stock company. So students, since it is of 6 marks, you have to first of all explain what is joint stock company. Joint stock company refers to a company which is formed and registered under Companies Act 1956. And then you have to explain its features. So its features are chapter 4 of your book mentioned. First one, artificial legal person, because it is created by law. Separate legal entity, it means the company is separate or distinct from its owners. Perpetual succession. Limited liability of partners as per the extent of their shares. Common seal. Transferability of shares. Shares are transferable only in case of public companies. It is not allowed in case of private companies. The next, separation of ownership and management. So owners are different from management. We appoint professional managers to manage our business. So they are different from owners. So there are 7 characteristics. You can mention any 6 or any 5 of them in the question paper. Question number 27. Explain any 3 saving schemes operated through post office. You all know that post office also undertakes some of banking activities. So in your book, chapter number 8, on page number 116, some important saving schemes offered by post office are mentioned. The first one is post office saving bank account, 5-year post office recurring deposit scheme, post office time deposit account. The fourth one is post office monthly income scheme. So there are basically 8 saving schemes. You can write any 3 in exam in this question. Question number 28, explain the various modes that may be adopted while purchasing goods. Students, we have studied this chapter number 12 in purchasing and selling, that there are 3 easy way or modes that can be adopted while purchasing. First one, purchase by inspection. Next, purchase by sample. And the third, purchase by brand. So this is very easy. You have to write their names as well as explain them in detail because it is of 6 marks. Students, page number 182, chapter 12, modes, as I told you, there are 3 modes of purchase. One, purchase by inspection. Second, purchase by sample or pattern. And third, purchase by description or brand. So this is how you will write your answer. Question number 29. What parties are involved in consumer protection? Explain their role in protecting the interest of the consumers. So students, there are basically 3 parties involved in consumer protection. The first one is the consumers themselves. As it is mentioned, self-help is the best help. Second party is the businessman, the service providers, the manufacturers. And the third one is the government. So you have to write their names and also mention their role, that how they can protect the interest of consumers. As you can see here, parties to consumer protection, page number 271. There are three parties. Self-help is the best help, that is consumers themselves. B, as regards to businessman, and third, for government. So these are the important parties of consumer protection. The last question, students, explain any four qualities of a successful entrepreneur. So first of all, you have to define who is an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is a person who is creative, innovative, someone who identifies the business opportunities. He has the ability to be a risk. And entrepreneur is someone who is combining other factors of production and he starts the business. You can define entrepreneur and then you can mention its qualities. So the qualities that a successful entrepreneur should possess, the first one is initiative. He should be able to take first step or first initiative, willingness to assume risk, ability to learn from the experience, motivation, self-confidence, decision-making ability. So there are six important qualities that a successful entrepreneur should possess. Students, I would like to mention here that chapter 17 and 18 is very important. The last chapter, chapter 20, about entrepreneur, it's very important. Don't leave these three important chapters. All the chapters are important, all modules are important, but do not leave these chapters because most of the questions that come are from these chapters. So this is how you will solve the question paper for business studies. If you like this video, please share with your friends. Thank you so much. Have a good day.